Hosanna. Alleluia, Hosanna, Alleluia, Alleluia, Hosanna, Alleluia, Alleluia. He says, Song of Victory, Alleluia, Hosanna, Alleluia,
Alleluia.
We have peace with God,
Alleluia,
peace in our mind,
Alleluia,
Oh, good, he said,
Alleluia,
I want to God in the highest.
Hallelujah.
The Lord be praised forever. Today is a day of joy. Today is a day of celebration. Today is a day of thanksgiving. And as we are praising God, as we are thanking God today for what he has done, for what he has promised to do, and that he's not going to fail, the peace of God, the joy of God, the spirit of celebration and happiness shall overshadow you and your family in the name of Jesus. Praise ye the Lord. Just as I've said, today is a day of thanksgiving. This is our month of total peace. And what we have been considering since the beginning of this month is how to enjoy peace. There is no doubt about it. Jesus Christ has given us peace. According to John chapter 14, verse 27, he said, "Peace I give unto you. My peace I give unto you." So he has given us peace. And because he has given us that peace, we must know how to enjoy it. And one of the ways to enjoy total peace is what we are considering today, and that is to be grateful. Praise the Lord. Peace is a gift from God. And our response to the gift of God must be gratitude. Must be thanksgiving. The way you receive the gift of God will determine how long that gift will be in your hands and how you are going to enjoy it. Many of us will not enjoy the blessing of God because we don't receive it with a joyful heart. We don't receive it with joy. And that is why today our focus is to be grateful. Praise the Lord. In 2 Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 16, Paul knew he had the understanding of peace. That is why he said, "Now the Lord of peace himself give you peace." It's a prayer. Always by all means, the Lord be with you all. Praise the Lord. That means peace is very, very important. For him to pray that prayer that God give you peace always by all means. One of the means of receiving and enjoying the peace of God is to be grateful. Praise the Lord. He said, "The Lord be with you all in Jesus' name. Also, in Romans chapter 15, verse 33, he said, now the God of peace be with you all. Amen. Praise the Lord. Our God is a God of peace. God makes and gives peace. Praise the Lord. He does not only give peace alone, he makes peace. Because he knows, without peace, life will be tough and rough. Without peace, life will be miserable. What's the strength that keeps us going in life is peace. That is why when Jesus Christ was going, he promised to give us peace, because he knows that without peace, you cannot reason well. Without peace, you cannot plan. Praise the Lord. It takes peace to think right. It takes peace to live well. Praise the Lord. And that is why he has given us the major ingredient for life. He has given us what sustains life. And that is peace. Praise the Lord. And that is why Paul also prayed that prayer in that second Thessalonians chapter 3, verse 6. Praise the Lord. Verse 16. Peace is a gift. And just I've said, what must our response to the gift of God must be thanksgiving. Praise the Lord. Because we don't work for it. It's a free gift. It costs God to send his only begotten son. We have peace, we enjoy peace, but it costs God something. It costs God to send his only begotten son to come and die for us on the cross of Calvary. This peace we are talking about costs Jesus his own life. What kind of value can you give to life? Praise the Lord. So for God to surrender his only begotten son, and for Jesus to lay down his life so that we can have access to peace, this God is worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be praised. This God deserves our gratitude. We have to be grateful to this God. What about if he didn't send his only begotten son? We would have died in our sin. What about if Jesus Christ did not die on the cross of Calvary? Remember, when he was about to die, he went to the Garden of Gethsemane. He prayed three times. The Bible says the sweat of his body was like a blood. That will tell you that it was not easy. But he beared the pains. He suffered for us so that we can have peace. So this peace, we must value it. And the only way we can value this peace is to be grateful to God. Praise the Lord. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. To be gratitude is the feeling of being grateful. One of the common sins of saints is sin of ingratitude. It's a common sin. It's common to every one of us. Oh, I sleep, I wake up well, yes. Many of us, we don't value it. That thousands of people slept, they never woke up again. David said, I lay myself down and sleep, for thou, Lord, has kept me in safety. It is the gift of God. Without peace, we cannot sleep. Those people that are troubled don't sleep. Praise the Lord. For you to sleep is a sign that you have peace. And that is why we have to be grateful. And this gratitude is a feeling. It's a feeling of being grateful. It's a feeling. To be grateful is to thank God for what he has done and for what he has given. Gratitude is a way of expressing our happiness for God's kindness, for God's mercy, for God's protection, and for God's blessing, and all the good things that he has done. So it is by being grateful, it is by expressing our gratitude to God that God will know that fully we value what he has given. Do you value peace? I praise the Lord. I pray many of us, we won't value peace until we are troubled. But I pray you will not be troubled in Jesus' name. Praise ye the Lord. There's one time God told me, say, you will not value what I've done until it is taken. Praise the Lord. I pray your peace will not be taken in Jesus' name. What to take with a levity hands? What to do appreciate? Is what some people are even, they want God to take everything they have, but to just give them peace. Somebody in pain. Somebody that is being troubled, we ask for peace. But this peace is what God has given to us without paying any kobo. So that is why today we are giving thanks to God. We are celebrating God for what he has done. Praise the Lord. Let's consider the benefit of being grateful. Praise the Lord. The spirit of gratitude produces contentment in all conditions. Praise the Lord. Spirit of gratitude produces contentment. When you are grateful, you'll be contented. And when you are contented, you'll be free from anxiety and worries, which are the enemies of peace. When you are contented, you will have peace. The reason why many people are troubled today, why they are running from pillar to post, is because they are not contented. But if you are contented with what God has done and you are grateful, your mind will be at peace. And that is why one of the ways to enjoy total peace is to be grateful, because it produces contentment. Praise the Lord. In Philippians, let's see Philippians chapter 4, verses 6 to 7. Be careful for nothing, but in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your request be made known unto God. Verse 7. Praise the Lord. He said, and the peace of God, that is what we receive when we are grateful to God. He said, and the peace of God, which passeth all understanding, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. The kind of peace you receive when you are grateful to God, the kind of peace when you value the gift of God, the blessing of God in your life, the kind of peace you receive is a peace that you cannot explain. You just know within yourself, you just know that you know you have peace. You can't explain it, because there is a kind of joy that will be bubbling in your heart. Praise the Lord. Because because when a man is contented, praise the Lord, everything in life will be at peace. His heart will not be troubled. Praise the Lord. So, and the Bible says in verse 8, okay, verse 7, he said, and the peace of God, verse 7, I'm reading verse 7 again, he said, and the peace of God, which passes all understanding, that you cannot explain, will keep your heart and mind through Jesus. I pray that in the name of Jesus, the peace of God will keep your heart together in the mighty name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Number 2, we are talking about the benefit of being grateful. Gratitude fits us for greater blessing. Hallelujah. When you are grateful to God, it will make God to do more. Praise the Lord. So it gives us access to greater blessing. In Luke chapter 17, God is ready to give us more and greater blessing when the precious gift and blessing are properly valued and appreciated. When you appreciate what God has done, when you give thanks to God for what He has done, when there is an impression in your heart and you know that what God has done for you, money cannot buy it. In fact, you can't buy the gift of God with money. That's why the Bible, Jesus Christ said, He said, not as the world giveth. Money cannot buy it. It's priceless. Peace is priceless. That is why we have to be grateful to God. Praise the Lord. So, Jesus answered, said, were there not 10 cleansed? But we are denied. Hallelujah. That means Jesus Christ was expecting. No, at the beginning, Jesus Christ didn't tell them to come back. He just told them, go and show yourself to the priest. But along the way, when they were all cleansed, one came back and worshiped Jesus and gave thanks. And Jesus Christ said, we are denied. So that means he was expecting the 10 to come back. God has preserved our life since the beginning of this year. God has preserved your family, all your children, everything, your business, your job. You have not lost anything this year. So let's be one of those lepers that came back to give thanks to Jesus. And let's see verse 18. He said, there are not found that return to give glory to God, save this stranger. In fact, the one that came back was a stranger. That means the 9 were Jews. That sin of familiarity. They just took it for granted. Praise the Lord. It is Jesus. He has been going about healing. They know everything about Jesus. They have been with Jesus. They know him. That is why. But this one, a stranger, value it. Praise the Lord. When we value the gift of God, God will give us more. He said, verse 18. He's at verse 19 now. And he said unto him, arise, go thy way. Thy faith has made you whole. They were healed before, but this time around, Jesus Christ perfected everything that concerned this man. It was not only healing he received, he was made whole. Not only his health was restored, life was restored, his destiny was restored. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Everything was restored. So that means when you give thanks to God, when you value the previous blessing and gift. It qualifies you. Gratitude qualifies us for greater blessing. And I'm believing God today, as we give thanks to God, as we celebrate the doings of the Lord, we don't let us say because we are not in the church. Let's do it in our home, in our various home. Praise the Lord. And it will be acceptable. Let's dance. Let's give glory to God. Let people around us, just like the David said in Psalm 126. He said, when the Lord told the captive of Zion, we were like them that dream. He said, the Indian have said that Lord has done great things for them. He said, God has done great things for us. Wherefore we rejoice. As they were rejoicing, they were celebrating. All the Indian around them, they had their voice. They said, that means God has done something for them. So sing unto the Lord. Let people hear it, and God will do more. And I pray you will receive more in Jesus' name. Psalm 85 verse 12. Psalm 85 verse 12. I want you to know, God still has something greater in his hand to give you. Praise the Lord. There is still greater blessing. So he's just expecting you to give thanks for what you have done, for what he has done, what you have received. And he will do more. He said, yea, the Lord shall give that which is good. Praise the Lord. And our land shall yield an increase. The Lord, I pray, that which is good, because to be made whole is better than to be healed. Praise the Lord. And as we thank God today, I prophesy upon you and your family, God will give you that which is good in the name of Jesus. Praise the Lord. And also, David said in Psalm 67, from verse 3 to 7. Psalm 67 from verse 3. He said, let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. Oh, let the nation be glad and sing for joy. For thou shalt judge the people righteously and govern the nation upon the earth. Let the people praise thee, O God. Let all the people praise thee. Then shall the earth yield her increase. Praise the Lord. So when we are grateful to God, he said, and we express our gratitude in form of thanksgiving, he said, then shall the... So one of the conditions that will make us to receive the best of the land. The Bible says, the Lord bless thee out of Zion, and ye shall eat the good of the land. There is still good in this land. Praise the Lord. And we are all going to enjoy it. We will be alive to enjoy it. There is good in this land. Praise the Lord. This time will soon be over. We will all enjoy. There is a blessing. This land. And the Bible says, one of the things that qualify us to enjoy the good of the land is when we are grateful, when we praise God, when we are grateful to God. He said, then shall the heart yield an increase. And God, even our God, shall bless us. Praise the Lord. I pray you'll be blessed in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. So let's give thanks to God. Let's be grateful. God always lavish his blessing on those that are grateful for what he has done. He will lavish it. Hallelujah. Another thing, number three, we are considering the benefit of being grateful. We taste the sweetness of God's gift and experience the miracle of divine multiplication and provision when we are grateful to God. Let me come again. We taste the sweetness of God's gift and experience the miracle of divine multiplication and provision when we are grateful to God. Do you see what we are missing? Praise the Lord. We enjoy divine multiplication and divine provision when we are grateful to God. John chapter 6, verses 11 to 13. John chapter 6, from verse 11 to 13. And Jesus took the loaves, and when he had given thanks, he distributed to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes, as much as they would. Verse 12. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, gather up the fragments that remain, that nothing be lost. Verse 13. Therefore, they gathered them together and filled 12 baskets with the fragments of five barley loaves, which remain over and above unto them that have eaten. Praise the Lord. You can see the wonders of being grateful, the wonders of gratitude. Jesus, despite what the disciples said, what can this food can't go around? It's not sufficient. It can't go around. Jesus then took it from them, lift it up, and give thanks. If you can give thanks for what you have, it will multiply. Praise the Lord. That is the wonders of gratitude. when you are grateful to God, when you give thanks to God, when you express your gratitude by giving thanks to God for what you are, even if it is not sufficient, there is a power of God, the blessing of God will come upon it and it will multiply. Immediately, Jesus said, lifted it up, gave thanks. The Bible says, and the food multiplied. 5,000 men were fed. And after that, they gathered 12 baskets of fragments left over. Praise the Lord. I want to believe that those 12 baskets were for the 12 disciples who didn't believe, who were troubled because what they have is not sufficient. Praise the Lord. Anything you have, God has a power to multiply. Remember that widow, the widow of the prophet, just small oil, just a little oil. I prophesy, whatever thing that is little in your house, as you give thanks to God today, it will multiply. I don't know, go back account. I don't know what you have in hands. I don't know what is about to finish in your house. The Lord said, I should tell you, as you praise God today, that thing which is about to finish your house, remember what Elijah said to that widow of Zarephath. He said, as the Lord God liveth, he said, that flower we not finish, and that hall we not finish. In the same way, I stand by the power of God. I speak by the spirit of prophecy. I say that little one, the Lord will multiply it. As we give thanks to God today, your store shall not be empty. Your pocket shall not be empty. What is about to finish this week, you will experience the miracle of multiplication and divine provision in the name of Jesus. Shout hallelujah. Why should we need to be grateful? Praise the Lord. Number one, the salvation of our soul. Praise the Lord. Just I've told you, it cost God his only begotten son. The salvation of our soul cost Jesus his own life. It was not easy. It was painful. The Bible said he was led like a sheep to the slaughter. He didn't utter a word. The Bible said he saw the glory ahead. He endured the death of the cross. It was a painful death. It cost God something. So let's value it. Praise the Lord. If you buy an expensive car, will you just drive it anyhow? Will you just allow somebody to hit it anyhow? Won't you take care of it? You will take it to car wash. You wash it clean every time. Praise the Lord. If care is not taken, it will be your second wife. What about God? What about Jesus? Who died for us? He gave his own life for us. He died on the cross of Calvary for us to be saved. Praise the Lord. So we need to be grateful to God for the salvation of our soul, because it is the salvation of our soul that qualifies us for the blessings of God, that qualifies us for the gift of peace. Praise the Lord. In 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 9. 1 Peter chapter 1 verse 9. Salvation. Praise the Lord. He said, receiving the end of your faith, even the salvation of your soul. The end of our faith is salvation. The greatest gift of God to mankind is salvation, because it is from that salvation that we have access to other blessings of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So celebrate God that you are saved. Celebrate God that you have the gift of God in you, that you are saved. The Bible says he has translated us from the kingdom of darkness into the kingdom of his own begotten son. Colossians chapter 1 verse 13. That is what the Bible says. God translated us. Praise the Lord. So there is a need for us to be grateful to God for the salvation of our soul. If somebody say, oh Lord, I thank you for the salvation of my soul. I thank you for saving me. Praise the Lord. Number two, we need to be grateful to God for the gift of the Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. Just I've said, it cost Jesus his own life. He said, it is expedient for me to go. For if I do not go, the Comforter will not come. And for Jesus Christ to go, he has to die. Praise the Lord. He died on the cross of Calvary to become a spirit. When he died and he ascended to high, then he said, and I will pray the Father, and he will send another Comforter. So he died for us so that we can receive the gift of Holy Spirit. Praise the Lord. And I've told you, for us to be calm, for us to have a feeling of calmness in the time of danger, is the power of Holy Spirit. It is by the power of Holy Spirit. For you to rejoice, even when what you have is not enough. For you to have faith. For you to celebrate. For you to be happy. For you to be contented. They are all gift of Holy Spirit. There is a need for us to celebrate the gift of Holy Spirit. Do you have the Holy Spirit? Celebrate it. You didn't pay for it. In fact, thank God for our generation. We received the gift of Holy Spirit without anything. The disciples went there for 10 days. Praise the Lord. Before they received the gift of Holy Spirit, they were in the upper room for 10 days. But thank God, when when this message came to the Gentiles in the house of Cornelius, the Bible says, as Peter was yet speaking, the Holy Spirit came on them. They didn't wait for it. They received the gift because they received Peter, they received his message. Praise the Lord. So there is a need for us to celebrate it. Praise the Lord, because it called Jesus Christ his own life. Number three, why we need to be grateful. We need to be grateful for the life of God that is in us. It is called eternal life. Praise the Lord. It is called eternal life. It is the life of Christ. It's a life of contentment. It's a life of joy. It's a life of peace. In the midst of trouble, it's a life of peace. It's a life. It's the life of God in us. We have to celebrate it. What made the difference between you and non-believer is the life of God in you. Can I tell you this? It is not all the people that you see that are alive, that are living. Some people are existing. Hallelujah. Just like animals. Animals are not living, they are just existing. And I want to tell you, everything in animals is in man. Praise the Lord. Talk about kidney. Talk about every organ is in animal. But they are existing. They are not living. Praise the Lord. The same thing, it is those that have the life of God in them that are living. The Bible says, as men have given themselves to this world, he said they die while they are still living. So there are so many millions of dead corpses walking all around. You see them in big cars. They are not living. They are existing. Praise the Lord. Devil can kill them at any time. Hallelujah. They are food for the devil. But those of us that have life, we are the one living. Praise God. We are alive. We are not just alive. We are living. Won't you celebrate God? Praise the Lord. Won't you praise God? Won't you be grateful to God that you have the life of God in you that make you a living being? The Bible says, and God breathed in the breath of life into Adam, and Adam become a living soul. Praise the Lord. We are a living soul. That song says, every living soul, praise the Lord. We are a living soul. We are not a dead man. We are not just a sitting like animals. We are a living soul. And that is why the devil cannot just take our life. Our life is precious. Our life is hid in Christ. And Christ is hid in God. And for the devil to kill us, for the devil to take our life, he has to pass through Jesus. Praise the Lord. And you can't take what you don't give. Praise the Lord. So Satan has no access to us because we have eternal life in us. Praise ye the Lord. Hallelujah. So because of that, there is a need for us to be grateful to God for the eternal life we have. Number four, why we need to be grateful to God. That God is mindful of us. Hallelujah. Amen. Can I tell you this? God has not forgotten you. You are still the mind of God. Hallelujah. That God is mindful of us. It's more than enough to give thanks to God. That God has not forgotten us. He said, a woman can forget the child of her suckling that she will not give herself. But he said, I, the Lord, will not forget you. So God has not forgotten us. We are in his mind, no matter what you are passing through. And that is what gives us peace in the midst of trouble. That our God is with us. He said, when you pass through fire, I'll be there with you. When you pass through water, I'll be there with you. So God is with us always. That is why we need to celebrate God. Psalm 8, from verse 3 to 6. Psalm 8, from verse 3 to 6. He said, when I consider, if you look at that place, he said, when I consider the heaven, the work of thy fingers, the moon and the stars, which thou hast ordained, what is man that thou art mindful of him? And the son of man that thou feastest him. Even the angel could not understand why God is so mindful of us. Even right from the beginning, before Adam and Eve sinned, God has made provision for their redemption. He said, behold the Lamb of God that was slain before the foundation of the earth. That means God was mindful of Adam. Praise the Lord. And even when he was pronouncing curse upon man, he made provision for our victory. He said, we bruise the heels of the woman. And the woman will bruise his head. Hallelujah. So that we need to be grateful to God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Now, how to express our gratitude to God? I've told you, gratitude is a feeling. It's a feeling of being grateful. And there is a need for us to express. You know, feeling is a feeling. Nobody will know how you feel until you express it. How do we express our inner feeling? How do we express that what God has done, we follow it? How do we express our happiness for what God has done? Praise the Lord. Number one, by thanking him with the words of appreciation from our mouth. Hebrews chapter 13 verse 15. We need to, he said, by him, therefore, let us offer the sacrifice of praise to God continually. That is the fruit of our lips, giving thanks to his name. So speak good word from your mouth. Talk about his goodness. Appreciate God. Mention the name of the Lord. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord. Number two, by singing spiritual song and hymns. Ephesians chapter 5, 19 and 20. By singing spiritual song. I mean spiritual song. Praise the Lord. I laugh many times when people say they are praising God and they are singing the song of prayer. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Spiritual song. Let's speak spiritual song unto the Lord. Ephesians chapter 5, verse 9 says, speaking to yourself in psalms and hymns and spiritual songs, singing and making melody in your heart to the Lord. Praise the Lord. Verse 20, giving thanks always for all things unto God and the Father in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Praise the Lord. And nothing, number three, how to express our gratitude. By giving a quality offering from our heart with cheerfulness. Praise the Lord. Many of you, since this lockdown, you don't give offering, you don't give tithe. Praise the Lord. I pity you. Praise the Lord. Has God forgotten his principles? No, he has not forgotten. The principle of God is principle of God. Whether the church congregate or not, the principle of God is a principle. Praise the Lord. He said, you have robbed me in tithe and in offering. But today, even if you have not been doing it, I want you to give an offering from your heart. It's not because some people say, oh yes, they are still taking offering. I'm not the one taking your offering. It is God that demands for your offering. Praise the Lord. And what can you give in return for what God has done? It's just a sign of appreciation. It's just a sign of expressing your gratitude to God. Praise the Lord. You see that in Psalm 96 verse 8. Psalm 96 verse 8. Praise the Lord. Psalm 96 verse 8. Psalm 96. He said, give unto the Lord the glory due unto his name. Bring an offering and come into his court. Your family where you are having the meeting is the court of God, because the presence of God is there. So give an offering. Praise the Lord. Number four, by dancing and making melody in our heart to the Lord. By dancing, making melody. Praise the Lord. It's not, at times you just think about the goodness of God and you'll be, there are some sound coming out of your heart. You are just making melody. You are just rejoicing in your heart. You are just ruminating and meditating on the goodness of God. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. So let us now do from number one to number four now. As we sing, Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Praise the Lord. I'm going to send this song to all the family. We'll sing it together. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Glory be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise ye the Lord. The Lord is good. Are you okay? Begin to give thanks to God. Offer God from your mouth. Speak good things. The Lord is good. The Lord is mighty. The Lord is excellent. How great, how compassionate, how gracious is our God. How awesome is our God. As we sing unto the Lord now, Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. We love you, we thank you, we worship and adore you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Heavenly Father, Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. We love you, we thank you, we worship and adore you. Heavenly Father, we appreciate you. Son of God, what a wonder you are. Son of God, what a wonder you are. You love us, you save us, you die for us in Calvary. Son of God, what a wonder you are.
Son of God, Son of God, what a wonder you are. Son of God, what a wonder you are. You love us, you save us, you die for us in Calvary. Son of God, what a wonder you are. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are. Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are. You lead us, you guide us, you live right inside of. Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are. Holy Spirit, Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are. Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are. You lead us, you guide us, you live right inside us. Holy Spirit, what a comfort you are.
So celebrate God and give thanks to God. Dance before Him. Make melody in your heart and sing praises unto God. Let people around you hear your voice. Let heaven hear your voice. And I decree that in the name of Jesus, the best that God has in hand, the good that has God has in hand, the best of the land, the good of the land shall be your portion in the name of Jesus. The peace of God that passeth all understanding shall keep your heart and mind together until the day of the Lord in the name of Jesus. In that house, there shall be no more sorrow, there shall be no more sadness, there shall be no more lack, there shall be no more wailing, there shall be no more glassing of teeth. The Bible said the shout of God will not cease in the congregation of the righteous. As you celebrate God today, I can hear the voice of baby in your house. I can hear the voice of thanksgiving coming from your family. I can see God turning around your life. I can see God turning your situation around. And all shall be well with you in Jesus' name. Glory be to God in Jesus' name.